Hello everyone, so this question was requested by one of you that how to calculate the correct normalized wave functions if the hybridization is given. Now I have pre-written it because I forgot to start recording. Now see, I just told you that in that pre-recorded video. So this is sp2, so we all know that in sp2 hybridized orbital we have contribution of s is 33%, and for p orbitals we have 66, and for sp hybrid orbitals we have 50-50, and for sp3 we have 25% s character and 75% p character. And how to calculate it? Just very simple. This is how, let's say this is sp, so this is 1 and this is 1, two orbitals are there, that means s will occupy half of the, if say we have 100%, then it will occupy half of it. So this is 50-50, and this is sp2, so 2 p orbitals and 1 is s, so total is 3. So s will occupy 1/3 of the 100, so 1/3 of the 100 is 33. And same for the sp3, these are 3 plus 1, 4 orbitals, and s will occupy 1/4 of it, so 1/4 of 100 is 25. So those who don't know, by this way we calculate the percentage of s and p characters. Now see, this question is very easy. So what you have to do is, I don't know from which topic or which class this question belongs, I consider in general chemistry. For this question, just take the square of this coefficient like we do in quantum chemistry. So if you will square it 1/3, it will come out 1/9, and if you multiply by 100, you will get around 11%. So it should be 33 for sp2, so it is wrong. Now see the second option, this is 1/√3. I'm writing this is 1/√3 for b option. So if you take a square, it will be 1/3, and it will be how much into 100, so this is around 33%. So this is correct. Now look for the p orbital, that means these two p orbitals should contribute 66%. So you can write this 2/√3 square for p. This will be 4/3 into this is 100, so this will come around, this is how much, this is 33, and this will come out 4 3 12, and 4 3 12 and 30, so this is 132%, which is greater than, obviously it is not answer. So let's take, so there is no need to go for this. Now look for the third option. So this is 1/√3, and we have calculated this 1/√3 will give you how much, 33%. Now come to this option, 1/√2. So this is 1/√2, take a square, this will be how much, this is 1/4 into 100, so this is 1/2, sorry, so this will be around 50%. That means for p orbitals to be 66%, this should be around 16%. So just take 1/√6 square into 100, so it is around 1/6 into 100, and it will come around 16.6. So we have 50 plus 16.6, around 66% for p orbitals and 33% for the s orbitals. So third is the right answer, and you can do this by yourself. Now so 3 is the right answer. So this was very easy, you can calculate easily. So for the next time, thank you, and subscribe to the channel if you haven't, and bye.